Everyone has a favorite dinosaur, including me. You know that dinosaur from the first Jurassic Park that looks super cute at first, but then whips out its huge frill and projectile-spits acid saliva at Nedry? Yeah, that's Dilophosaurus, and it's my favorite. Don't ask me why, maybe I secretly wish I could spit acid at people. Dilophosaurus went extinct around 190 million years ago, but what if, somehow, Dilophosaurus didn't go extinct and lived on all the way until modern day? That's what we're going to talk about right now on Life's Biggest Questions. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that imagines the impossible. I'm Charlotte Dobre. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe for more great topics just like this one. Firstly, I should start this topic by saying that there is no conclusive evidence that any dinosaur had poisonous saliva, and there wasn't any evidence at the time the movie was produced either, which is like super upsetting, I know. But for the sake of this video, we are going to assume that Dilophosaurus did have acid saliva because it's my video and I can do whatever the hell I want. Okay? Plus, it's not like we can ask a Dilophosaurus, do you have acid spit? In case you forgot, Dilophosaurus is extinct and has been extinct since 190 million years ago. And there is some speculation that it may have used venom to kill its victims because its fangs resembled that of a rattlesnake. So I'm just gonna go with it, and you're gonna like it. Alright, so where was I? Dilophosaurus, despite its small size in the film Jurassic Park, was actually one of the largest carnivores of the early Jurassic period. It was believed to be about 7 meters in length, weighing 880 pounds. It probably didn't have a gigantic frill in real life, but it did have two thin crests of bone on the top of its head that it used for mating displays. That's actually how Dilophosaurus got its name. Its genus means two-crested lizard. It also had a long tail that it could have used as a whip in a fight. Ooh, kinky. Dilophosaurus could travel around extremely quickly. It was light on its feet and used scent as a part of its hunting technique. That being said, most experts agree that Dilophosaurus couldn't jump very high. It's believed that they hunted in small packs. Perhaps one of the most interesting facts about Dilophosaurus is that it may have had a warm-blooded metabolism, like mammals, and of course, humans. So first of all, because Dilophosaurus had a warm-blooded metabolism, its habitat wouldn't be restricted to tropical areas, which would mean absolute ecological chaos. Think about how many animals would be eaten by Dilophosaurus. They would essentially eat anything they could, even huge animals like bears. Maybe this would mean that the world would be incredibly populated with Dilophosauruses. Dilophosauri? Dilophosauruses? You get it. And the only way other animals could survive on Earth is if they lived in trees. As I stated previously, most experts agree that Dilophosaurus could not jump very high. Perhaps early human civilizations would have resembled that of the Kuruwai aboriginals on the island of Papua New Guinea. The Kuruwai people live in elaborate treehouse communities. For the majority of history, humans would have been tree dwellers. Perhaps we would have maintained our ability to climb trees like our ape relatives, all to get away from the hungry Dilophosauri on the ground. Of course, if Dilophosaurus did overpopulate the Earth and humans had to live among them, they would probably become an integral part of our diet. Fast forward to modern day, and humans would find ways to live on the ground. Buildings and houses would be made of tough materials, or maybe humans would live underground or in suspended cities. If humans ever entered the habitat of Dilophosaurus, they would need to remain in vehicles that protected the people inside from both the acid spit as well as Dilophosaurus's sharp teeth. As we learned in Jurassic Park, getting out of these vehicles in the presence of Dilophosaurus would be a terrible idea and would almost certainly end in death, especially if you lost your glasses. Thankfully, Dilophosaurus hasn't been around for many millions of years. It would probably be pretty difficult for humans to coexist with them. For now, I'm Charlotte Dobre, and you've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. If you enjoyed this video, you should also check out our playlist, Biggest What Ifs, clickable on the screen right now. If you want to connect with me, my Instagram handle is posted in the description of this video. And make sure you subscribe to notifications by clicking the bell, and we'll see you in the next video.